Hi, this is Ali and you're watching the ChatGPT Features video series on Learn Awesome. In this video, we shall discuss formatting output with ChatGPT. We generally tend to treat ChatGPT as a chatbot, which it surely is, but when we ask it something, a lengthy paragraph upon paragraph of textual output is not always what we are looking for. You must have heard the phrase pictures worth a thousand words, but in a world without pictures, you still have a bunch of options to make the output more readable and suitable to your needs. Examples include bulleted or checklists, tables, HTML documents, markdown tables, comma-separated files, graphs and charts, and so many more. So is a formatted output all that we need to have more readable, well-defined output? Sadly, no. A good output does not just mean graphically organized text in these formats. It also needs to be well-structured. An output in the form of an article can also be termed as formatted output. A well-defined article has a heading, summary of sorts, then main points separated by subheadings and paragraphs followed by a conclusion. This is formatted as well as structured output with a proper flow and is also doable with proper instructions to ChatGPT. Letters, emails, stories, newspaper articles, brochures, CVs are all examples of formatted and well-structured outputs. With a well-read ChatGPT, all of these output types are within your reach. You are in total control of the output that ChatGPT generates for you. As an example, if you are generating a table, you can set the heading, limit the characters in each table cell, provide separate formatting instructions for specific columns, etc. Similarly, you can instruct it to format your HTML output with heading types and content formatting for each section. As an example, you can instruct it to come up with a short form of your favorite book in HTML format with an H2 heading for each chapter, and then a 200-word summary for each chapter. If, say, trying to come up with recipes, you can tell ChatGPT to come up with ways of making tea per region. Note that tea making is an art form where the techniques are very different. For example, Turkish tea makes no comparison with the way it is done in India or UK. You can ask ChatGPT to come up with a structured HTML output where regions are separated by H1 headings, and then each tea making technique needs to be presented as step-by-step instructions with ingredients listed up top. It is not always feasible to have a clear understanding of intended output up front. It sometimes helps to expand on the initial understanding step by step. As an example, you first ask ChatGPT to come up with a basic outline of an article with just the headings. Then you instruct it to come up with bulleted points for each heading, and then add content for each bullet points with summary text and so on. Expanding the prompt bit by bit by leveraging context retention capability of ChatGPT. This technique is formally known as chain prompting, and you can look it up to have more enriching experience with ChatGPT. A useful technique to generate intended output is by examples. This is formally known as one-shot prompting. In this technique, you provide a full example or template of intended output as input, like you write a template or provide a full story in your prompt as example, and then ask ChatGPT to use this as example to come up with a story on a totally unrelated topic, and it would follow the same template to generate the answer. A very novel way of improving the output is to give input and then ask ChatGPT to improve or critique it as a certain role. Taking earlier example, you provide an example story and ask ChatGPT to critique it. You can ask it to critique it for both output structure and flow. You can also assign an appropriate role to ChatGPT to help with critique in the subject matter by assigning it subject matter expert role. That way, you get what you need to instruct it in next prompt from ChatGPT itself. I hope you understand how to use ChatGPT to generate output formats as per your desire. If you like the video, please like and subscribe to be notified of upcoming videos. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.